Chef-d'œuvre culte et hypnotique, Blade Runner ressort en salle dans son montage Final Cut. Une version déjà disponible en Blu-ray et DVD, agrémentée de quelques discrets effets numériques et bénéficiant surtout d'une remasterisation à tomber. Si cette ressortie permet de découvrir ou redécouvrir le film dans des conditions optimales, à savoir sur le plus grand écran possible, elle nous offre l'occasion de rencontrer David Webb Peoples, qui a réécrit le scénario original d'Hampton Fancher, lui-même inspiré d'un roman de Philip K. Dick.
Hampton Fancher had discovered the book himself. And then a friend of his has had a motorcycle accident, so they had $10,000. And Hampton said, you know what we should do? We should option this book. And he went to meet Philip K. Dick and got the option.
David Webb Peoples est arrivé pour sa part tardivement sur le film.
I need you, Dex. This is a bad one. The worst yet.
I had written a kind of a strange movie called My Dog's on Fire. And Tony Scott wanted me to rewrite it for him. And Tony Scott, at the time, hadn't made a feature yet. I knew that his brother, Ridley Scott, who had made Duelists and Alien, was making a big science fiction picture called Blade Runner, but I didn't know anything about it. One day, they wanted to screen the original Mad Max. So Tony arranged for us to go see it too. So we got to see it, and I met Ridley Scott.
Memories.
What? David Webb Peoples, qui n'était pas encore le scénariste reconnu d'Impitoyable ou de L'Armée des Douze Singes, est embauché sur Blade Runner grâce à l'appui de Tony Scott.
Whoa, was that thrilling? The thought that I would work on a big, real picture that was in production was exciting. So they put me in a suite in the Chateau Marmont and gave me this script to read. And the script was terrific. It was really, really good. And I said, wow, whoo. I said, too bad. So then Ridley Scott and the producer Michael Dealey came to see me and said, well, did you read it, right? And I said, yeah. And they said, well, what'd you think? And I said, I think it's terrific. I said, I wouldn't know what to do to make it any better, right? I was too new and too naive in Hollywood to know that nobody cares what the writer wants to do, it's what the director wants to do. And the producer said, well, I think Ridley has a few ideas.
Shakes. Me too.
Ridley, who's very full of ideas and energetic, had Hampton writing things over and over and over again, draft after draft, and Hampton, being the first writer, wasn't getting paid. He was getting really exhausted, and Ridley can exhaust you. I'm telling you, he's a brilliant man, but he can really tire you out.
I've seen things you people wouldn't believe.
Webb Peoples doit alors retravailler le scénario de Fancher.
And I know I had to do a lot of expository material, and when I look at the film now, I cringe because it's the all that stuff when Deckard is taken into the place that's Union Station and does all that talking. I wrote that stuff, and it's embarrassing.
Et enfin, David Webb Peoples apporte ses propres idées, dont certaines étaient étonnantes.
I wrote a scene where Tyrell, his brain was inside a shark. And there were all sorts of cables coming off the shark so that they could listen to the shark talk and tell them what to do, which was a reference to a film called Colossus of New York, which came out in the 50s. I remember his brains in a little jar? That scared me when I saw it. I was about 9 years old, I think. I was terrified of that movie.
Dernière évolution du scénario de Blade Runner, la voix off de Deckard, retirée par Ridley Scott depuis le premier remontage sorti en salle en 1992.
When I started on the film, there was voiceover written very much in the style of the film noirs. By the time he finished shooting, the story had gone all over the place and had some problems. So the voiceover was no longer a luxury to put in for mood, it was a necessary crutch to deal with the story. So then Ridley lost control of the film. Somebody, we didn't know this at the time, but the voiceover was rewritten then.
Et c'est avec cette voix off, écrite par un tiers, que Peoples et Fancher ont découvert Blade Runner, ce qui a donné lieu à un savoureux quiproquo.
He wouldn't see me.
Basically, it was awful. It was embarrassing. And I thought, well, Hampton wrote this, but he had to write it because, you know, you're getting paid, you have to do what people want, and the picture had some problems, so that's what Hampton had to do. And I found out later, Hampton thought, poor Dave, I'm not going to tell him how awful that is because he had to do it. He's a professional and they told him to do it. Then only later did we learn that this other person had written this narration.
Embarrassing.
Ce Final Cut, qui sort aujourd'hui en salle, est la 7e version existante de Blade Runner. Et même si elle est présentée comme définitive, David Webb Peoples est loin d'être satisfait.
To this day, if we could have back the good narration, it would make the movie better.
Il n'est donc pas dit que ce Final Cut de Blade Runner soit le dernier montage proposé au public.